So chapter 3, databases, data warehouses, and data marts. This ties in absolutely together with Microsoft Access, which we're learning as well. So the learning outcomes this week is to truly understand what is a database and what is a database management system. That is simply the software that lets us use a database. There are several different design models. This week we're going to focus on only the relational database model, which is what Microsoft Access uses as well. And it's the most popular. We'll look at some of the components. And before we even get started, let's just look at some of the jobs in this area. So this is a company called Glassdoor.com. And it lists the 50 best jobs, not only computer related jobs. If I scroll down, you'll see things here like speech language pathologist and business development manager. So it's not just high tech jobs. But if you look down the list, and we have earnings, how many jobs there are open, and also satisfaction levels. So the number one of all, computer related, of course, front end engineer. By the way, I would expect typically to see high tech and healthcare jobs right now. So front end engineer, that's designing the systems that a user would see from the user standpoint. Programmer, then here we are, data scientist, number three, and number six, data engineer. To be honest, I don't really know the difference between these two positions. 102,000, 107,000 as the median salary. Now that is nationwide. Typically in California, we are higher than that. But if you go down the list, just so you see, nursing managers, you know that's in big demand, 85,000. A Salesforce developer is also somebody developing. Salesforce is a software, a database for marketing, tracking sales, products, etc. So going down the list, even things like accounting manager, 85,000. That makes these numbers look pretty good for data scientists, 107 and 102. Okay, let's go back to our presentation here. So that's some of the jobs. We'll look at business analytics, what's its role in the decision-making process. What is big data? And you're going to hear a lot about that. And that's what we're dealing with all over the world now. Analyzing data and how does it apply to our business. And then database marketing and things like, you know, using our list of clients and what they've purchased to market more things or new things to them. So in terms of a database, what is a database? It's really just a collection of related data. And you all understand the basics. It's just like a file cabinet. So in a file cabinet, you put lots of information. You have files and records. So we're going to deal with a hierarchy here. Let's use students, let's say Grossmont College as an organization. So in the hierarchy of data, we deal with fields, records, and files. Fields are, example, first name, last name, street address, city, date of birth, etc. And all students have the same fields, but with different data. All those fields about you is your record, or all the products, or all the faculty, or all the driver's licenses, all will make records. It's all everything about one student. And then a file is all the students, or all the faculty, or all the classes, or all the vehicles, or whatever. So this is what you're going to become very familiar with over the next few weeks. Fields, records, and files. And the DBMS, the database management system, of which Microsoft Access is one of them, is the software we use for creating the data, storing it, maintaining it, etc. It just makes it much more efficient. So here's an interaction little diagram. You are the user. You say, I want to know some information. Let's say I want to look at all the English majors with over a 3.5 GPA and over 30 units for some kind of scholarship. That question is called a query or an inquiry to the database, which then searches the database. Here's the data. The information gets retrieved and organized through the database management software, and it's returned to the user in the form of a form or a report or something on the screen. That's how this whole thing works. And you use this all the time, so this shouldn't be anything brand new. What kind of data do we have? Internal data. At Grossmont College, data that we've generated, students generate, grades, things you enter, and external data, other colleges, information from the state. So all organizations have, most have internal data and external data. And then what we're going to deal with when we get to Microsoft Access, we will be modeling and setting up the structure. So there will be another video specifically about Access where we will use this. We will design the structure. What are the rules? Example, if it was payroll, maybe the rules say hours worked cannot be more than 50 in 1 week, or pay rate cannot be less than whatever minimum wages are. So there's a lot of rules we'll put in to get good data. Now, in the relational model, you are already familiar with this. It's very similar in some ways to Excel. So we'll use a two-dimensional table of rows and columns. It's just like a spreadsheet. Let's say we had a spreadsheet of all the students at Grossmont College, and each row may be one student. The columns could be the fields. Again, student ID, first name, last name, and so on. And we define all this through something called a data dictionary. This is where we define, okay, for first name, we want 25 characters. For state, we want 2 characters and a default value of maybe CA for California. Things like that. So we can design the data in the data dictionary, and we can design and lay out our database. We have in every table, there's some unique data. For example, at Grossmont College, it's student ID. No two have the same. For the state of California, vehicles, maybe it's vehicle identification number or driver's license number. At the bank, it's your bank account number. Every table or every file has to have some way to identify each record. Now we'll get into the concept of foreign keys and then mixing and matching. Maybe there's every car has a license plate, but it's owned by somebody. So this is where it gets a little more complicated. One person can own multiple cars, or one student ID can take multiple classes with, that's the course ID number or section number. So we'll be getting into this more depth when we study Microsoft Access. Every database has what's called an engine. And that's, each database is a little different. Every database management system, and there are many. There's Microsoft Access, there's Oracle, there's MySQL. There are many different ones available. And this is the tool that lets us store, manipulate, and retrieve the data. Now, I want to say, let's say I'm in payroll and I want to, well, let's say the example, I'll go back to it, Grossmont College. I want to see all the students in one department that are over a certain GPA that have so many units completed. That would be a logical request I would make from, and I'm a user, and what that's doing is creating what's called a query, which then will retrieve the data using the database product. So again, back to the data dictionary itself, that's where I lay out the structure of the database. It's called a data dictionary, and just like a dictionary defines words in whatever language, such as English, this is where we define the structure of the files or tables. We're going to use the word tables instead of file. This is where we define it. And I can make changes to this. I can add and delete fields. I can say, oh wow, those for last name, we need more than 25 characters. We want 35. We've got some people with long last names or hyphenated names. We define data types, such as pay rate, maybe a numeric or a currency field, where last name would be an alphabetic or a character field. Some other field types, yes, no, or date. There's lots of different kinds. So here's where, this will be the last slide for this presentation. I'm trying to keep these into 10-minute blocks, if possible. So this is where we can add, delete, modify, etc., the data. Add records. Modify records. Somebody's name changed or their address moved. So we have to have a what's called a query language. And you all understand this. QUE in Spanish means K. We use question, inquire. QUE kind of means like, what? So we have one standard query language, which is called Structured Query Language, or SQL, which works on pretty much all databases in the world today, which is a very powerful concept. So if you can learn SQL, which is not that hard. We do teach it at Grossmont College. That's a very good skill, and it's in big demand. So that's one way of getting the data. In Access, we'll also use what's called query by example, where you kind of lay out what you want the question, what the question to be, and what you want the results to look like. Okay, well, let me pause there, and you can continue on with part two.